Once you are happy with the area, date, and band combinations used in your Landsat 5 and Sentinel 2 imagery, both can be exported to open in QGIS. Once you're happy, click Run again to make sure that any changes you have made have been registered, and then click on the Tasks tab. You will see two new tasks, Sentinel 2 and Landsat 5. Click Run next to Landsat 5, and then under Drive folder, type GEE, and then give your file name a suitable name, and click Run. Do the same thing for the Sentinel 2 export. They can run at the same time without causing any problems. Wait for these tasks to complete. Once your two tasks have completed, there is a shortcut for opening them in your Google Drive folder. Simply hover your mouse over one of the tasks and press the question mark button, and then click the blue link Open in Drive. And your Google Drive folder will open with your images. Simply right-click to download these, then switch to QGIS and use the Open Data Source Manager on the Raster tab to add them to a map. You can then use this data to make maps of your study area. Have a go at creating one or more maps in QGIS using false color composites from Google Earth Engine to illustrate changes in landscape that have disturbed or that threaten archaeological sites in your area of interest. If you want to save your script to refer to in the future, you can do so by clicking the arrow next to save and then save as, and it will be saved in your scripts window.